Lisa, can you tell us a little bit about your race today? Is the mic on?
First, I was really nervous before start, and but now it's over the first race, so I'm really happy about first place with Simon together, and we had really good shooting, both of us, and I'm not so satisfied with my running performance, but I think it's getting better at the next races.
Did you get the answers you were looking for today before the race? Did you get the answer about your form? Is it like you hope it should be? Or
of course, I wanted to start that I will be faster on track, but it's not so easy. I think I have good preparation before the races, and I need a lot. I need more fast training to get better on track.
How is it with the Olympics coming in February? Is it okay to not be top shape now, or is it you have a lot left to the top form?
Maybe it's a good way to be not in the perfect shape in the beginning of the season, but I think I do not focus so much on Olympic Games. I will focus on World Cup, so I don't think about Olympic Games already.
Good. Simon, you were second last year, win this year. How important is it to start with a win in the season?
It feels even nicer than becoming second, but our goal was to be among the best three today, and yeah, we did it, and that's really great.
You've always been a very fast shooter. I thought you shoot nearly faster today than you did last year. Was it like that, or did it just look like that?
The first standing was a little bit complicated for me, I have to say. I had to slow down, and you can't always make it really fast on the shooting range, but the last shooting was really good for me, and it felt also better, and yeah, I'm really happy with both.
You satisfied with everything today, or was it something that you're not satisfied with?
Of course, everything can be better or faster, but when you're on podium or on the first place, it's okay, and I don't analyze too much.
When you come to the range for the last time and there are several teams just behind you, do you think another way, or is it the same drill, the same like every time you come to the range?
It happened not that often to me that it's really a daily routine, but sometimes you're afraid and sometimes you feel good, and when you come to the first range, and today it felt good and I was happy about it.
What about the rest of the week in Östersund? What are your goals here for the rest of the week or the next week coming?
I hope to get the top 10 in the next races. It's always important at the start. I think I don't feel that bad, and yeah, we will see. It's really hard competition, and the first competition maybe the hardest.
Well, it went out good. We go to Germany also. If you can send a message to us, Vanessa, we will be happy. Tell us about your race. What's your opinion about your race today?
Yeah, I was very nervous before the race. I never did a single mixed relay before, and I knew it's important to shoot fast and clean, and everything goes so fast, but I'm very satisfied with my race. Perhaps one or two less of mistakes, but we are second, and the Austrian team was the favorite team for me, so I'm confident.
What's the biggest difference for you as an athlete to do the single mix than the other races, like a mixed relay, for instance?
Yeah, the break between that, you have so short laps, so you if you shoot one mistake, you have to be very, very fast on the lap that you that you are better, and that's for me the main difference.
Satisfied with second place?
Yes.
Eric, it was a very, very last quick last lap from you. It looks like you are in very good shape.
Thank you.
You had that feeling yourself?
I had a good feeling on the uphill, for sure. But it was a tough race from the beginning. Austria was always in front of us, and they shot so good today. Just two mistakes at all, and Vanessa and me, we had much more mistakes. But it was the first race. The first race, you are always nervous before. And but for this, I think we did a good job. We had a good shape. We had a good shooting performance. Our service team did a good job on the skis, and overall we could be proud of ourselves to be second, and yeah, that's a good thing to looking forward for the next races here in Östersund.
What do you think about the mixed relay, the single mixed relay? It changes a lot all the time in the top of the race.
It's a very close race. The last shooting of the women, there was six or seven women together in the standing shooting. This is very, very close, and I like the World Team Challenge on Schalke. I like these short laps, much shooting. I like these races, but I think I have some ideas to make the single mix better than now. But I like these competitions more than other.
What are your ideas to make it better?
I think without spare shots, like on Schalke, that you have one lap, one shooting, and then the exchange to the other girl or woman, girl or man, and just one lap, five shots, and then the penalty loop or no penalty loop. I think this could be more exciting for the spectators at home or in the stadium.
Maybe it's coming.
Maybe it's coming. I should talk to Anders Spesberg.
Or you should stop your career and be a member of the IBU.
No.
Yeah, good race.
Maybe if the money is correct, then I go to the IBU.
You have to talk to Anders anyway, I think.
Okay.
Good. Congratulations. We go to Kazakhstan. Galina Vishnevskaya, great race today. What can you tell us about your race? You have to turn it on, Marina. So, yep.
Что ты можешь сегодня рассказать про гонку?
Сегодня могу рассказать про гонку. То, что мне очень сильно понравился старт, мне понравилась атмосфера, хотя и болельщиков было очень мало, но было очень приятно слышать, как они кричат по трассе. Хочу сказать спасибо своему личному тренеру и тренер, который здесь нас поддерживает. Большое им спасибо.
I just want to say that it was a really good atmosphere at the start, and there were not so many fans, but they were very supportive, and I would like to say thank you to my personal coach.
You looked very strong on the skis today. Are you better shape than last year?
Сегодня хорошо выглядела по ходьбе. Ты чувствуешь себя сильной в этом году?
Сегодня я стартовала очень хорошо. Я видела, что мои соперники тоже очень хорошо бежали, но первый круг мне показалось, что у меня лыжи ехали немножко лучше, поэтому я решила выйти вперед и помочь в то же время своим соперникам и себе. Вот. И заходя на рубежи, было легкое переживание, потому что все-таки первый выстрел, первый старт.
Of course, I was very nervous because it was the first start of the season and the first shooting in the season. I could feel that my skis were much faster the first lap. That's why I was trying to go faster to have a little bit of gap over my competitors.
And Maxim, there was an incident the last downhill. Tell us what happened. Was a crash there?
Что случилось на последнем спуске там?
Ну, если честно, я даже не понял. Я бежал вот последний подъем, который и идет к башне. Мне Валерий Николаевич Польховский говорит: терпи до конца, сзади еще двое тебя догоняют. Я просто из последних сил растолкался на спуск, опустил голову. Просто ехал, сидел в стойке, поднимая голову, а спортсмены из Швеции и Украины просто лежат. Я понял, что это мой день, мой шанс, я должен его использовать. Я, если честно, даже не видел, что произошло. Мне самому интересно. Я хочу просто пересмотреть эту гонку и понять, что произошло, что случилось.
I was going to be honest, I don't really know. I was going on an uphill, and then my coach was telling me from behind, you should go and try your best. And then I go down the hill, and I open my eyes, I look up, and I see the athlete from Sweden and Ukraine just lying there. So basically, I would like to watch the race myself to understand what is going on. I just realized it was my chance, and I grabbed it.
So you were not involved in the crash yourself?
То есть ты не был там задействован в падении?
Нет, ни в коем случае я не был. Я был чуть-чуть позади.
No, I was not. I was a bit far behind.
How important is it for the Kazakh team to start the season on the podium?
Насколько важно казахской команде начать сезон на подиуме?
Я думаю, это фантастическое начало. Это, можно сказать, впервые в истории биатлона казахского такое начало сезона. Мы очень рады, очень довольны. Мы проделали огромную работу летом. Я не могу сказать, что мы были готовы на это, на этот результат, на этот подиум, на третье место, но мы сделали много и боролись сегодня до конца. Ну и сегодня удача была на нашей стороне, можно сказать так. Мы очень довольны. Спасибо всем, кто поддерживал, болел. Ваша поддержка сегодня очень сильно сказалась. Спасибо всем.
I would just like to say that this summer we worked really, really hard, and this is a fantastic beginning of the season for us. And of course, I should say we also had a bit of luck, but I would just like to thank everyone who supported us and who cheered for us. Thank you.
And thank you. Are there any questions to the three teams? Otherwise, they will stay another few minutes if they want some one-on-one interviews. Otherwise, we say congratulations and thank you. And good luck the rest of the week in Östersund.